Hey y'all, I'm Mandy, and this is Mandy in the Making. Today I'm going to bring y'all along for another What's for Dinner. Hey y'all, it is Saturday night, and I am getting dinner started. It's not going to take long, which is exciting, because it's already 5:30, so I am trying a new recipe. It is a white chicken chili recipe, and it uses ground chicken, which is so odd to me, but I think this is the first time I've ever tried ground chicken. Honestly, comment below, let me know, have you ever tried ground chicken? But I'm gonna get this started. I'm gonna brown this up, cook this along with the onion, but it also calls for chicken broth. I think it calls for one can of chicken broth, so there's a little bit left in here, and I've got a new one back there. It calls for some ground cumin, some oregano, some pepper, two cans of cannellini beans, and some diced green chilies, and that's it. So let's get started. All right, so this is starting to cook, and I figured I would throw in just a little extra seasoning. So I'm going to use my Old Faithful and just sprinkle that in there with it just to give it a little extra flavor. Okay, so now that the chicken is cooked through, it says to mash up one can of the cannellini beans. So I'm just kind of coming in here with this little mix and chop thing I have from Pampered Chef and mashing up one can of it in here. And then once I mash this up somewhat, then I'm going to add in the other can. These were drained and rinsed, by the way. And then I'll add in the green chilies and the seasonings and the chicken broth and bring it to a boil. So that's what I'm working on now, is just chopping, kind of mashing this stuff up. I feel like I might need to get something else to mash these up. I don't know. I guess it's working. It's just taking a minute. That's what I'm doing now, and I'll show you what everything looks like once I get it all combined. All right, so I brought it up to a boil. This is what it looks like. So now I'm going to reduce the heat, cover it, and simmer it for like about 15 minutes or so, just to kind of let the flavors all meld together. And then in the oven, we've got crescent rolls. So, I mean, it would have been better if I made cornbread, but real life, y'all. I wanted dinner ready in like 20 minutes, and that's what we're getting. Okay, y'all, so it is ready. I put a little bit of sour cream on top, and then this good spicy cheese that we love. It's the hot jalapeno habanero jack cheese. And then we've got crescent rolls too. So let's eat. Hey, y'all, it is Monday night, and we are about to start dinner. This is what we're having tonight: Tex-Mex skillet chicken and rice. Sounded really good. I got it out of the Food Network magazine back in September. It has just been sitting in the front of my recipe binder, and I haven't tried it, so I thought this week sounded like a good week to try it. So this is everything that we're going to need. It calls for frozen rice, which just, I didn't even know there was such a thing, y'all. But I'm just going to use this brown rice, this instant salsa verde. It called for scallions separated, so the white separated from the green. It calls for Mexican cheese, which we have a little bit left, but the rest of it we're going to use this hot cheese because that's what we like. Ground cumin, salt and pepper, sour cream, red bell pepper diced, minced garlic, broccoli florets, and rotisserie chicken. So that is what Steven's doing now. It's pulling all the chicken apart so that we can put it in, and I will show you how we get started in just a second. Okay, so we're getting dinner started. The first thing I'm going to do is cook this instant brown rice. I'm going to do about a cup and a half of rice because it says 3 cups of rice go into the mixture. So I'm guessing it'll double. I could be wrong on that. We'll find out. Anyway, I'm going to cook that. It only takes 10 minutes total to cook. I'm going to do that. Then I'm going to heat up some olive oil in this huge pan. The only reason why we're using this one is because it can go under the broiler, and that's what it tells you to do. So, in here, after I heat up the olive oil, I'm going to saute the red bell pepper, the scallion whites, the broccoli, some salt and pepper, and the garlic. And then at the very end, added the cumin, it said, to like toast it. I don't know. That's odd to me. And then I will add in the salsa mixture. This does not look good, but it is 3/4 cup of the salsa verde. 3/4 cup of water and 1/2 cup of sour cream. So that's going to go in along with the rice and the chicken and 1/2 of the cheese. And then we're gonna top the rest of it with the cheese and stick it under the broiler, and that's it. So this meal is gonna be ready really quickly. Okay, I forgot to grab the camera and show y'all, but once I sauteed all those veggies together, I added in the salsa mixture, the rice, and the chicken. And now I'm just letting this kind of simmer for about 3 minutes or so. And then I'm gonna stir in half of the cheese and then sprinkle the rest of the cheese on top and then pop it under the broiler, and it's gonna be time to eat. And we didn't need all of the chicken from that rotisserie chicken, so I'm saving the rest of it in this little container for maybe lunch tomorrow, make some more rice and throw some chicken in with it. I don't know. I'm sure this will be eaten. I'm not too worried about it. All right, so I put the cheese on top and Steven is gonna pop it under the broiler for about, I don't know, just a couple of minutes just to let it melt really well, and then it's gonna be time to eat. Y'all, if I do say so myself, that looks amazing. So me and Steven put a little more salsa verde on top of ours just because we're extra like that. But I've had a couple of bites, they've had several bites, and what do we say?
We say that.
That is the universal code for please make this again and again. Hey y'all, it is Tuesday and I am getting dinner started. It's going in the crock pot. We're making cheeseburger soup tonight. It's pretty easy. The hardest part is just chopping up all the veggies that go in it. But I've got my carrots, celery, onion, my potatoes diced, my 3 cups of chicken broth, and some basil and parsley. All of that's gonna go in here on low for like 6 to 8 hours. And then I'll come back and show you what we do right before we serve it. All right, y'all, so dinner is ready. I browned up the ground beef just a little bit ago and then did the rest of the process and melted the cheese in here. If you have not seen me make this on my channel before, be sure to check out the link below. It will give you all the instructions on how to make this yummy soup. Hey, y'all, it is Thursday night. There was no Wednesday night on here because we went out for Thai food. I just didn't feel like cooking, and my hubby wanted some Thai food, so that's where we went. Tonight, I am making cracked out chicken tater tot casserole. It's one of my faves. I will leave the link to the video where I've made it before, and I will also have the link to the website where the recipe came from. The only thing I've changed up as far as the recipe goes was advice from my mama, was to put the tater tots on top so that they get more crispy. Other than that, I follow the recipe to a T. These are all the ingredients that we need, and then we also need chicken, which Steven is over here cooking. We ran to the store and got some tenderloins because I forgot to thaw out the chicken for this, real life. So he seasoned them up, he's cooking them, and then we will shred that up and put it in the casserole. I just had to show y'all how pretty this chicken turned out before I cut it to pieces. Y'all, if you don't have one of these mix and chops from Pampered Chef, I think you can get them other places too. You totally need to get one because that's what I'm using to chop this up, and it makes it really easy. All right, so now I'm literally going to mix all of this together in this bowl and then put it in a 9x13 pan and then top it with the tater tots and stick it in the oven for about 45 minutes. All right, y'all, it just came out of the oven. Steven's gonna scoop it up for us, serve it up. This is a good comfort food dish, y'all. So if you've not tried this, it's a crowd pleaser and it's so easy. All right, y'all, we put a little bit of green onion on top, and it is time to eat. Thank y'all so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. Don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you did, and if you haven't already, go ahead and hit that subscribe button and join my YouTube family. Thanks, y'all, and I'll see you next week. Bye.